Hello gorgeous people, this is Chris from Macombo and I'm here with Samsung's Galaxy S9. We just picked it up yesterday, we've been having a bit of a play, liking it so far quite a lot. I'm just going to do a quick side by side with the OnePlus 5T, which of course comes in at a considerably smaller price, but offers very premium specs just like the Galaxy, to see which one might be best for you. So first of all, in terms of the design, as you can see, both phones feature a screen that pretty much fills that front panel. The Galaxy S9, of course, does have slightly slimmer bezels above and below, and to the side as well, thanks to that nice wraparound design. But all the same, both of them pack a rather big screen. You get a 6-incher on the OnePlus 5T and a 5.8-incher on the Galaxy S9. And they've got a reasonably comfortable feel, a decent bit of heft to them as well. The Galaxy S9 ever so slightly more comfortable to clutch and to use one-handed. Thankfully, they do both support one-handed modes as well. For instance, you can drag down the notifications bar just with a quick slap of the fingerprint sensor on the OnePlus 5T, so you don't have to reach all the way up to the top. And the Galaxy S9 supports various one-handed modes as well. Just a quick flick towards the center of the screen, if I get it right, there we go. And you got a one-handed mode, which just makes it, again, a bit easier to handle when you need to. If we flip both phones over, you'll see that the OnePlus 5T rocks a nice matte chassis. It's a nice sort of metal finish to it. Feels nice and durable, and certainly we've been rocking it for a couple of months now and absolutely no signs of scratches or anything like that. The Galaxy S9 of course sports the usual glossy finish. It does scuff up a bit of a storm, but thankfully in this midnight black model you can't really see that. Both phones come in a couple of different hues. The OnePlus of course launched in sandstone and that gorgeous red colour just before Valentine's Day. Galaxy S9, you can pick it up in a lovely lilac-y purple and a nice sort of hazy blue as well. Petrol blue, I believe they call it. Great naming, as always. Both models, of course, rock a rear-mounted fingerprint sensor, as you can see here on the back. It's almost built into the camera lens on the Galaxy S9, whereas it just sits alone by itself on the OnePlus 5T. We find it slightly easier to find on the OnePlus 5T. When we're just groping around on the back, just give it a quick tap and you're in. Whereas in the Galaxy, it sometimes takes a few little taps before we actually manage to get it unlocked, and sometimes we just kind of give up a bit. Fingerprint sensor is not responding. Brilliant, that's a great start. Hopefully that's just a temporary little bug that will be sorted. However, thankfully you do get facial recognition with both of these phones. So we just unlocked the lock screen, there you go, and both of them you're straight in. The Galaxy S9 actually supports dual face recognition and Irish scanning? It scans if you're Irish, iris scanning. So it's actually dual security, which makes it that little bit more secure. It does take a little bit longer, as you saw in that demonstration, but it's worth doing if you're a bit paranoid like I am. It's also worth noting that the Galaxy S9 is fully water resistant, but the OnePlus 5T is not, so you definitely don't want to get this bad boy wet. As for those displays, it's a 5.8-inch Super AMOLED screen on the Galaxy S9, and it's a 6-inch AMOLED screen on the OnePlus 5T, so not a massive difference in terms of the tech used and all that kind of jazz. As you can see, nice vibrant colours on both handsets as well. Greens, blues, reds, they all really, really shine, and it's nice and crisp in both cases as well. Although the Galaxy S9 does have the edge in that respect, it's a Quad HD plus 2880 by 1440, whereas the OnePlus 5T rocks a bit of full HD action. And of course, it's an 18:9 stretched aspect ratio in both cases, so well suited to the likes of your Netflix movies and things like that. Both of these blowers are rocking a bit of Android Oreo action. And of course you've got the usual bonus features thrust on top. On the OnePlus 5T you get some bonus customization features which you can get stuck into. You've got the likes of the shelf feature, which just gives you shortcuts to all your favourite contacts, widgets, things like that. And a few other bonus settings as well, such as a reading mode and a gamer mode as well that's stuffed away in there. You also get a gamer mode in the Galaxy S9 as well. It's just really, really good, basically for making sure you don't get any notifications disrupting you or anything while you're busy getting your game on. And of course, as mentioned, the one-handed mode on both the OnePlus and the Galaxy S9 as well. But you get a whole bunch of bonus features on top of that on the Galaxy S9. It's absolutely stuffed with gesture recognition, lock screen security features. You can set up the always-on display to exactly how you want it. All kinds of great stuff shoved away in there. We're going to do a full tips and tricks to show you all of the stuff that you can actually do with this handset. It's quite a lot. But the UI experience is great on both of these handsets. They are recognisably Android, and as you can see, you get a good, strong, smooth, everyday experience. The smoothness is helped along by the fact that they are powered by really good chipsets. You get an Exynos or a Snapdragon 845 in the Galaxy S9, backed by 4 GB of RAM, and as you can see, it's super, super nippy. I've seen a couple of little stammers, but that's probably just because it's early software, still sort of getting used to it. Of course, you get a good bit of Bixby action if you love Bixby, we're not massive fans, to be perfectly honest. On the OnePlus 5T, it's a Snapdragon 835, so the previous generation. If you've got the Snapdragon model of the S9, that's a little bit more up to date, more energy efficient, but you are backed by 6 or 8 gigabytes of RAM, depending on which model you get, which is frankly nuts. And certainly no complaints in terms of the smoothness, they are both super, super nippy. We're not actually allowed to run any benchmarking tests on the S9 just yet, so I can't show you a comparison on Geekbench or anything like that, but stay tuned for all that kind of stuff for the full review. So what about the storage? Well, on the Galaxy S9, you get 64 gigs of storage. As you can see, a chunk of that is already used up. I think it was about sort of 13 gigs when I first got it. On the OnePlus 5T, you get a choice of either 64 or 128 gigs. This is the Midnight Black model, so it comes with 128 as standard. However, of course, you can bung a micro SD memory card into the Galaxy S9 up to 400 gigabytes, I believe it was, whereas there's no micro SD support on the OnePlus, but then to be fair, 64 gigs of space will keep you going even if you download a lot of Spotify tracks, a lot of Netflix movies, things like that, so I wouldn't worry about it. And when it comes to the battery tech, you get 3,300 milliamp cell packed away in the OnePlus 5T, and it's great. It gives you about a day and a half of life usually between charges, even with pretty full-on regular use. And of course, you do get a bit of dash charge to bring it back up to speed once it does run out. And there is a battery saver mode if you really need it. On the Galaxy S9, it's a 3,000 milliamps, not quite as large, but hopefully the energy-efficient processor and all that will do the job. If you dive in here, you do of course get the power saving mode. You can go either mid or max depending on how desperate you are. Both of these phones do charge up via Type-C USB, although the Galaxy S9 also supports wireless charging as well, so if you've got a bit of extra cash, you can spung out on a wireless charger. So what about that camera tech? Well, in the case of the OnePlus 5T, you actually get a dual lens snapper, as you do have for the last couple of generations. It's a 20 megapixel main lens and a 16 megapixel secondary lens, and it really, really does the job in pretty much any conditions, even low light conditions. It usually takes some really, really nice snaps. Dive into the camera app, and it's a nice, simple snapping experience. Just snap away, nice and easy. You can take some nice portrait shots of your subject, which just adds a nice bit of a bokeh effect, really helps them to stand out. And you do have a small array of random special features that you can use as well, such as a bit of slow motion. You've got pro manual controls. You can shoot time-lapse as well. And you can shoot up to 4K resolution video with really, really strong image stabilization. The camera on the Galaxy S9 is just a single lens snapper. On the standard S9, you have to upgrade to the S9 Plus for that dual lens snapper, but it's still really, really strong. It's a 12 megapixel. It's actually dual aperture. You can swap between f2.4 and f1.5 depending on the lighting conditions. So again, the low light results we've seen so far have been really good. So go check out some of our camera samples and everything for a bit of that. And it's absolutely stuffed full of bonus mods as well. For instance, the new super slow motion mode, which uses up to 960 frames per second at 720p, and that's got an auto mode as well, so you don't miss the action. And of course, you've got the new AR emoji mode, which takes a little snap of you and turns you into a cartoon. Lovely stuff. And once again, you can shoot up to 4K resolution video, but you can actually do that at up to 60 frames per second. And again, the image stabilization is really good at 4K. Go check out our video samples of that. As for the front-facing camera, it's an 8 megapixel on the S9 and a 16 megapixel on the OnePlus. And that, in a nutshell, is the Galaxy S9 versus the OnePlus 5T. Just a quick rundown of some of the specs and the main features. So let us know what you think in the comments below. Which one would you be more tempted by? Definitely interested to hear your thoughts. S9, a bit more premium in some respects, but also a lot more expensive. So hit us up, and thanks for watching, everyone, and love you, bye!